travel because sometimes you just cannot stand people on your vacation. Now, there are many advantages to traveling all by yourself. You decide on what there is to do. You have the opportunity to find yourself, to reflect, to the whole eat, pray, love thing. You are more inclined to meet new people. You get out of your routine. And whoever says you cannot do it all by yourself has clearly never lived the experience. But for those of us who have, who are planning to travel all by themselves, I'd like to welcome you to today's video where I talk about my experience of traveling by myself, what are a few things that I learned, and I'm going to share them with you. I have moved to 5 different countries in the past 7 years. Basically means almost every 1.5 years I would have to pick up and leave and start over in a new place. I have also sometimes went to foreign destinations either for work, either for my own personal enjoyment, all by myself because either a friend couldn't go, either I was the only one interested in the said destination. So my first tip is, whatever your excuse is, just put it aside. Whatever you are afraid that's going to happen, for now, it is all in your head. Until you do not put one foot in front of the other and you do not make the leap to traveling by yourself, to booking that flight, booking that accommodation, you'll miss out on one of the best experiences that there are. It is a chance to get to know yourself in a way that no one ever has, and possibly you have never known yourself ever before. So do not even wait. Move on to tip number 2. Make a plan, pick a destination, establish a budget. Whenever this trip is bound to happen, it will never happen unless you start making a plan for it. Now, I have made another video where I talk about my 5 steps to planning a trip and another 2 videos speaking about budget and budget mistakes. So make sure that you tune in to see those. I will link them down below. But basically, starting somewhere, deciding on something will make this trip look more real and will give you a sense of organization because now you are able to see where am I going, when am I going, what am I going to do there. My first trip all by myself was actually me moving to a foreign country where I knew no one, where I made all the budgeting mistakes that you could possibly make. I have learned quite a lot, but here I am now, alive and well, so if I could do it, you can do it. As soon as you are done with the logistics and all the practicalities, do not forget to take notes. This is a tip I got from someone who travels a lot by herself and has these small notebooks that she keeps for every single destination. And the idea is actually quite brilliant. Since you are traveling all by yourself, there will not be that one other person that you can share impressions with and talk about your day-to-day and talk about the things that you see. Instead, write it all down. You would be surprised the kind of memories that our mind chooses to filter out. This would explain why we look sometimes at a picture and we say to ourselves, oh, I do not remember having taken this picture, but look what a beautiful memory it is bringing into my life right now. And this will be the same with the notebook. Pick up the old-fashioned paper and pencil and write down anything. Write down an idea. Maybe this solo trip will serve as inspiration for your next book or for your new YouTube channel or for your new Instagram account. Maybe you have a passion for cooking and maybe you want to write down in this notebook all of the beautiful foods that you are trying while you are on this trip. Maybe you want to describe the color, the taste, the ingredients. Maybe you would like to reproduce these recipes as you go back home. Or maybe you just want to describe the feeling you had as you were sipping on an espresso while you were in Portugal, watching the sunset over the Douro Valley. You know what? I know it. Number 3 has to be safety. Someone needs to know at all times where you are. The simplest way would be to send a text to a family member or to a friend giving out your coordinates for the day. If you are constantly on the move, update them as you are changing locations, destinations, or hotels. Always keep an emergency contact card in your coat. I know that most people like to keep these in their wallet because that is the one thing that we do not change every single day. However, your wallet can get lost or it can get stolen, and then a bunch of other safety measures. Don't look confused. Say no and be decisive about it. Do not be afraid to be rude. I know that many times we entertain people because we are not familiar with their culture and we want to avoid being rude. However, when you are alone and you are doubting the situation that you are in, The good girl or good guy act has to drop. My fourth tip is save absolutely everything on your phone. Whether it is your reservation confirmation or the address of your hotel or that favorite restaurant you want to go to later, make sure to either download or screenshot the information that you need so that it is readily available at your disposal any time of the night or day. Traveling by yourself means taking all precautionary measures so that you do not have to depend on someone else or on Wi-Fi when you need to get from point A to point B. Many times Wi-Fi might not even be a solution or it might be extremely expensive, so you have to make sure before you leave your Airbnb or your hotel in the morning that everything is properly saved on your phone. Google Maps has this awesome feature where you can download your itinerary for the whole day. So assuming that your day will be divided between two or three monuments, you can actually save those itineraries beforehand to make sure that you always have access to vital information. Another tip that I spoke about in my previous video about traveling on a budget, how to travel for cheap, is getting yourself a spot in a hostel. Now, I know we said we would be traveling by ourselves today, but just in case you would like to interact with some people, it is always a nice option to have. In hostels, you might share the room with other people, but they also have the option of a private room. So if you prefer to have your own privacy while not spending too much and also having the option to meet other people when you get bored, this might be a very good option for you. Now, let's not forget that we are doing this solo trip because we want to discover something new. So be curious, interact with locals, ask about their daily lives, ask about the hotspots of the place that you are in. This will make sure that not only you avoid tourist traps, but you also get a feel of the culture of the place that you are in. Italy is one of my favorite destinations for this because even though I speak no word of Italian, locals make every effort to understand me and to interact with me.
Io voglio la pizza. Non facciare niente. Ma che sei questo? Ma che bella giornata. Bella la Italia.
And with my broken accent, people seem to enjoy teaching me something new and I personally loved learning something new from them. Did I manage to get to where I wanted to go? Maybe not. But this is why you have English. Another tip I have for those of us who are planning to travel by themselves is pack light. My absolute dream is travel with only a carry-on bag. And I have made another video talking about how I pack my carry-on bag so that I take all of my essentials and that I don't have to drag a lot of luggage with me. No one else is going to see you. You are all by yourself. Sometimes we might drag a bunch of stuff to our vacation thinking that we would like to impress someone or maybe to do a date night. However, as Beyoncé put it, me, myself, and I don't need those really high heels that are so uncomfortable you probably should have given them away anyhow. So ditch the extra luggage. Take outfits that are very complimentary. Take only those pieces of clothing in your luggage that are very appropriate for the climate where you are going. Take that really cute pair of jeans that makes you feel really good and also look really good, and maybe just a couple of sweaters next to it that you can mix and match and create different outfits according to your mood. Last but not least, this is my most valuable tip. Solo travel does not only have to be about vacation. Replace your home office with your international office. For those of us working from home or for those who have the kind of job that can be done from far away, this might be a very interesting tip. Between the ages of 22 and 25, I have actually worked from home, which might seem like a big nightmare to some and the biggest dream to others. There were a lot of advantages related to this decision. However, the biggest one of them all was the fact that I could work from anywhere. As long as I was able to log in during the typical 9-to-5 Western European time, I was good to go. This is what allowed me to work from a number of different countries. I would sometimes spend a week in Spain, I would spend a month in France or a month in Germany. So the way that I would do this is I would clean up my apartment, put it up for rent on Airbnb, and then grab the cheapest flight towards the cheapest possible destination. Either a friend's couch or some exotic beach somewhere. Even though I would have to work during those hours, the rest of the time, I had the time to explore. So it was kind of like a vacation outside of my working hours. When I would work from France from my mom's house, I would be online during the day, during the typical 9-to-5, checking on emails, responding to clients, and I would typically do it in a cafe where I can get the nice vibes and feel that Parisian atmosphere and that excitement of being in this wonderful city. And then in the evening, I would go out with my mom, we would go see a show, or we would go to a nice restaurant, or go out shopping. My advice here is to keep it simple, sublease, and then use that money to rent another place in a new destination that you would like to know more about. By living an experience like this, you really get to see what life would be like in another place, really get out of your comfort zone, and who knows, you might discover that, wow, you were destined to live in Barcelona by the beach. I feel like I want to hear from you. What are your tips for solo travel? How do you do that? What apps do you use? What is your favorite thing to do when you are in a new place all by yourself? Leave your answers down in the comment section and I'll make sure to respond. Thank you so much for watching this video. I can't wait to see you again next week.